I'd be here on the other side of 9 o'clock, and I'm trusting that you're there, wherever there is, on the other side of 9 o'clock. Welcome back to Nightline. We've been blessed tonight. Miss Mabel was with us. We had a caller that called in and said she had been there 24 years ago and said the cooking was great back then. That's 24 years ago. So come on, give that dear lady a call if you would. And on this last half hour, Michael Basmajian, Scott Daniels are our guests tonight. And you'll be interested in hearing what God is doing in them and through them there at the flea market there, the Barnyard Flea Market, actually, on Highway 101, fairly close by where I live. And unbelievable as it may sound, I don't do flea markets. I never have. But there are a lot of you out there that do. We'll be talking about that. Remember, too, that you've got the number right over here, 864-244-1616. Can you remember that? Our prayer partners are standing by. Many of you have called in tonight. We'd love to hear from you. And we would. And if you don't know the Lord Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, people are ready to encourage you. They'll pray a sinner's prayer with you. Yeah, they will. Maybe you just need to talk to somebody. We have folks available, and they want to talk to you. So please give us a call. And I want to remind you, as I always do, we're always in need of prayer partners. Amanda does a fabulous job here, and if you or your class or elder board, deacon board, or whatever it might be, if you'd like to be a prayer partner, one night a month, okay, or a quarter, call her and just let her know we're interested in doing that. I will tell you, it will change your life, okay? It will. And it puts you in contact and it puts you in touch with people who are hurting. And maybe you've never ever led anyone to the Lord Jesus, and you could come here and they call and you pick up the phone and you pray a sinner's prayer with them. Yeah, you could do that. So don't ever underestimate the power of God. Michael Basmajian is going to sing for us now. Prodigal Son, Michael!
Had everything there was to have, but that was not enough. My father's house was clean and pure, but I was rough and tough. I got together all my toys and headed for the door. I took along the fortune my daddy worked hard for. I spent it on the wildlife, brought pleasure, it brought pain. And if I had a second chance, I'd do it all again. Cause there's something in my nature that makes me run and hide. And even though I'm better off by my father's side. My father was waiting for the day that his lost and dying son would find a way to come back to the place where his eyes could see my face. His love take my emptiness away. Prodigal, you're not worthy as a servant or a son. Prodigal, come home, come home. I started thinking of all the things I tell him when we met, not looking at his angry eyes, but fall down at his feet. I tell him I'm no longer fit to be known as his son. I earned the keep just like the rest, like the hired ones. I say, Daddy, forgive me, I can't call you Daddy no more. Ever since I turned my face and walked out your front door, why are you embracing me? Remember all I've done, and all he said was, welcome home, my dear but living son. My my father was waiting for the day that his lost and dying son would find a way to come back to the place where his eyes could see my face and his love could take my emptiness away. Prodigal, you're not worthy as a servant or a son. Prodigal, come home, come home. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Michael Basmajian. And tonight, as we come together on this a little bit after 9 o'clock, Scott Daniels and Michael Basmajian are over here with me. What can I say but welcome back, gentlemen.
Boy,
what a joy to have you.
And
a joy to get to see your son.
I'm telling you why he's here from Norfolk, Virginia.
I know it.
I love it.
I know, as you do. I want to know something. Now, let me start with Scott. And then I know we'll all chime in.
Okay. But can I ask you a question
quick? Please.
Now, Michael asked me to ask you this question. So
go ahead.
We want to know the answer to this question. So
yes.
We want to know who your makeup person is.
Her name is L'Oreal.
Yeah, you go.
That's about all I can
L'Oreal.
Say. If I find out that Mike Davis put you up to that, I'll get him good.
Yeah.
I don't know any Mike Davis. I don't know who that is.
You
know,
but he's safe. I love it. All right, I want to know something.
Yes, sir.
Tell me about the ministry there at Barnyard Flea Market. I mean, obviously, it is booming.
It is. It's way beyond what we ever thought it was going to be. We go out there every Saturday and we set up the table. We put these pictures on the table.
Mm-hmm.
And people come by and they look at those pictures. And a lot of times they're going through the stuff that's on those pictures. Mm. And they open up to us. You know, we're just humble servants for Jesus. And that's what we do every Saturday. We go out there and talk to people. You know, we pray with them. We talk to them. You know, we try to encourage them. We try to show them the love of Jesus.
Right.
And that's what we do
and
every Saturday.
And y'all pay for your spot there, don't
yes.
you?
Yes, sir.
And it's the same spot every time,
same spot,
right?
8:32.
And what time y'all, from 8:30
until? 8:30 to about 12 or so.
Okay. And right now, during this time, it gets a little warm, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. But you know what? As they come through the flea market, the stories we're going to tell tonight are going to set it on fire, I'm telling you.
Well, I want to hear. Tell us some stories. Mike, kick it, lead it off.
All right, lead it off. This one's my favorite. I'm standing behind the table, and there's a couple fighting right in front of the table. And there's this little six-year-old girl named Anna. And she's looking at me. I'm like, okay. While these guys are still fighting, what's your name? She goes, Anna. I said, Anna, what could I pray for you for? I want my parents to quit fighting. So what I told her was, you know what? When you get mommy alone, I said, talk to her and tell her how much it bothers you. A six-year-old girl.
Yeah.
That's, for me, is like, wow.
Mm.
But I mean, we're still getting people with cancer out there. We're getting a lot of people with a lot of things going on. Even one of our friends out there who did pound cakes. What was his name?
John.
His name John. He's got cancer, really bad. And we just sent him some cards and stuff. But he won't take any phone calls yet. But
what about Scott? Do you have any stories that just really jump out?
Well, I'll tell you, the last time we were there, I was coming back to the market. I just went to the restroom and I was coming back. And I stopped at another table at the next building from ours. And we started talking about the Lord. We're talking about our salvation stories. And the guy proceeded to tell me, he goes, well, there's a lady come by here about 2 weeks ago. And she had depression really bad. And she stopped at your table and you guys prayed for her.
Yeah.
She came over here and told me, she goes, I was there for 15 minutes and my depression was gone.
Amen.
These guys prayed for me, and the depression was gone.
Amen.
I mean, it's just amazing the stories that we hear and the people that come by the tables. It's incredible.
Yes, would y'all have ever thought 5 years ago, 2 years ago,
no.
you'd be doing this?
2 years,
no.
yeah.
I mean,
not at all. It's just people think when we're out there, it's a flea market. There's no way we can do anything.
Right.
But the amazing stories, and we took your tape, we're writing up a journal, keeping track of everything.
Yes.
Because it's just week by week by week. there's so many things that happen in front of that table. I mean, we're just so happy, and we're going to continue to do it.
And you know, who's to say that down the road, after journaling so much, that maybe without the names or changing the names, you could publish that to show, from what happens in a flea market. Really and truly.
And let me see, there's one picture up there. Her name, what was her name? Tell the story. Name was Hope.
Remember her name was Hope.
There's Hope right there.
Okay.
And we were getting ready to leave, and she comes up to the table, and she starts looking at the pictures, and she picks them up, and she starts handing pictures out to people. Uh-huh. Oh, you need this picture. Here, so, ma'am, you need this picture. Sir, you need this picture.
Now show the next picture, guys. I'll tell you what she did. She prayed. Oh, guys, come out of the way. She prayed. Yeah, keep going. It's okay. She prayed for her a gal that went by, and it was just remarkable. It really was. Him. Good man.
Now, guys, is he somebody that works there? Or just...
He's across the way.
He's across the way. They sell golf balls. And he came over to the table. He comes over and talks to us all the time. And he's always saying how great it is for us to be there.
Yeah, there's
so
a guy.
Everybody appreciates us being out there.
He brought me soup. This guy here brought me soup.
Isn't that great?
At a flea market.
At a flea market.
Isn't that
I'm telling you what. We were just, and there she is, that's Faith praying. We had no idea who this girl was.
Uh-huh.
And she went ahead and knew about the prayer station. And she was praying for people right in front of there. We had no idea. And then she took off.
Wow.
I mean, that's faith.
Absolutely.
That's Jesus.
Absolutely. And, you know, we look at that and we see you two gentlemen inspire ministry in all of us. Because here, God put on your heart to go to the flea market.
Mm-hmm.
Now, come on, folks.
Yeah.
The flea market.
Yep.
To tell people about Jesus.
Where nobody thinks, we're talking strangers that walk by. We're with them for 10 minutes praying, and they go. We never see them again.
What would you average as far as people stopping by, not necessarily praying for them, but including that? How many folks would you have conversation with, or just to say hello to? What are you talking about?
I'd say probably in 4 or 5 hours, 6 hours, we're probably talking about 40 to 50 people.
Wow.
But people stop by and they look at these pictures.
Yeah.
And they immediately can tell the expression on their face that they need Jesus.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Give them, like you said, a whole lot of Jesus.
Absolutely. And I'm sure that when people come, I'm sure that you're in the process of pointing them not only to Jesus, but also to encourage them to get in a good Bible-believing church, wherever that might be.
Well, we go to RLC Church in Greenville, and we're trying to get them, because we go out there, and the band plays, and everybody in there is worshiping Jesus like you've never seen before.
Yeah.
And then when the message goes, Jimmy Miller, who's the pastor, a message to the heart.
It's an amazing place. The first time I went out there, I told Mikey I saw Pastor Jimmy on YouTube.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And I listened to the guy, and his message was intriguing to me. Right. And I had no idea about his church. I told him, we need to go to this church and see what it's all about. I said, the pastor is amazing. He just touched my heart. Everything he spoke about was down to earth, and he's so sincere, and he loved Jesus so much. You could see the passion within him when he preached.
Sure. And then
we went out there, and we saw the people in the church, and that was the most loving bunch of people I've ever seen.
Yeah.
And I was touched beyond anything I could ever imagine.
Yeah.
I've never met a finer bunch of people all together in one church. Yeah. It was just the most amazing place.
He's the music minister there, and I'll tell you what, he has a voice. And you know what they did? A couple weeks ago, I joined them to sing.
Did you?
So we got four girls over here. We got Cleve over here jumping up and down having fun. But, I'm singing with the girls, and I'm telling you what, they're really good. But you know what? They said, Michael, you're going to sing. And we do.
Yeah. And how long have you been singing, Mike? How long?
I've been singing Christian music about 30 years or so.
Okay.
Yeah, but I did it in Florida, and I came up here, a long time.
You and I met, maybe 8 or 10 years
ago? 8 or 10 years ago,
And been friends since. Of course, I had you in my church.
Yeah,
before I retired over there at Eastland. And the people really enjoyed you.
That was nice.
Then.
So I did a video. Yeah. We did Please Find Me, and that was so good.
It really was. And, and you and Scott need to be getting in churches.
Yes,
you
please.
Need to give them a call. And have them, the music will be great, and their sharing and testimony will be great. It really will. Now, with all that going on, with the anticipation, Do you see yourselves going more, somewhere down the road, putting words in your mouth, but do you see yourselves going more than just on Saturdays? I know Barnyard's only open Saturday.
Yeah, Saturday and Sunday. We go to church on Saturdays, though. I mean, I hope we can go there a little longer, but it's just, so, like you said, the heat out there, the people, it's just...
Now, are y'all undercover?
Yes, we are.
Okay.
Yeah, it's the first building on the right, and that's all A and B. Right. And that's what we wanted, to have a little air there, you know. So,
how many people pass through there, Scott? I mean, would you think at
the I would say probably 400 to 500 people come through there a day.
Yeah.
That's the whole day now, whole from day, start to finish.
Right, right. Yep. You know. Because, you know, I live near there. Just, and I'm just always amazed at how many cars are there.
Yeah. Well,
it's a big crowd of people.
And I've just never gone to the flea market.
I know.
Nothing
it's
against
a lot of
it,
fun.
Please. I just don't
We're still
it.
Waiting for you.
Yes, we are. We're waiting for you to come
I
out.
Just
for
a moment. Come by to see
just for a moment, you know.
You said that last time. You need to come by.
I know I did say that. So,
but it's all good.
So, Magali, if you're watching, you know I got to do that. You got
to
remind me.
I'm going to hold you to it.
Yeah.
Because you're there. What time do y'all get there?
8:30. 8:30, and we stay till about 11 or 12. Depends upon the float and everything. So.
Right, right.
But like I said, right away, we get people walking by, and it's...
Have you been hampered by this virus? People are still turning out?
People are, it's amazing. I mean, our church, everybody, you know, it's all set up really good. The pandemic isn't a thing at all.
People need
Jesus, them. I don't need a pandemic, you know?
When it's something like that happens, people need the Lord more.
Amen, I'm telling you what.
What's going on in the world today, they need, Jesus.
I'm praying for this world. I'm on my knees because this pandemic is putting the fear in everybody.
It is.
You know, it's just, it's hard.
Just an opportunity for us to witness because, you know, the people are going through so much. And there's so much going on with the virus and all this. It's an opportunity for us to reach out.
Right.
When people are struggling with all the stuff that's going on in the world. It inspires me to be able to go out there and be able to talk to people.
What questions are you asked? Or do you remember any certain questions?
Not really, because what happens when they see these pictures, we ask immediately for prayer. We want to catch them right away. Mm-hmm. What can we pray for you?
Right.
And like I said, with our book, we've had people with cancer. We've had people... everything. I mean, even our friend, I've just been praying for him because of cancer.
Yeah.
But praying for the whole world, it's just tough.
Man,
I'm telling you what.
But the work that you're doing, I mean...
We're trying.
People sometimes think that, well, I'm not a preacher. It has nothing to do with that.
Absolutely not.
All you have to have is a willingness and obedience unto the Lord. That's what took y'all
out.
We
have a church with walls. I'm telling you now, without walls over there, come and you'll... Just talk to us and, you know, help you out any way we can.
And they want, and I know y'all are encouragers.
Yeah.
I
mean, that's what we're there for. Huh?
I mean, I know.
Absolutely.
Yep.
And I encourage you, if you go to the Barnyard Flea Market now, that's on Highway 101, that would be exit 60 off the interstate, and you would come down like you're going to Woodruff, and you'll see Barnyard Flea Market, there it is. And you need to go in there.
Yep.
Speak to these guys. Yes, Mike.
We had a gentleman last Saturday. We were closed up, everything in the trunk. He comes up there and he says, I love Please Find Me. He says, when I heard your song, Please Find Me, it made me put it in tears because it was just way too much, you know.
Wow.
He said, it touched my heart that much.
It's funny because, you know, he talks about that song all the time, and that's the first song that I heard that he sang.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
I told him the same thing. I said, that song touched my heart unbelievably.
It's a great song. And,
yes, it is.
And Mike's going to be singing in just a moment. But, you know, Mike, why don't you do this? Scott and I are going to pray. You go ahead, get ready, get on set. Deacon will take you over there. And, Scott, we're praying. We're praying over here tonight for these who called in. Collectively, we're praying. I'm going to ask you to lay hands on this with me, and I want to offer this prayer. Loving Father, you know the need. We've prayed it before. We pray it again.
Yes.
Intercede with their need.
Yes.
Oh, God Almighty, I pray for healing, but I do pray thy will be done. I thank you for the ministry of Scott and Michael. Continue to use them, and we covenant together to pray for every need that's in these papers. I pray, Lord, you know them and have your way. Do thy will is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I want to thank, Scott, I want to thank you for being here tonight with us. Also want to thank Michael Basmajian. I want to thank Mabel Owens Clarke, who was with us in that first hour. We want to thank her. And, you know, we just appreciate the fact that you've tuned in tonight. So many have called in. So many were giving testimony. There's a lot of folks who are sick out there. We understand that. We really do. And we want you to know that Nightline is a safe place. We'll pray for you. That we promise, collectively and individually. Prayer partners are there. They're there for you to encourage you, pray, to lift you up. You know, we live in, as Scott was saying, they, one of their great ministries out there at the flea market is to bring encouragement. So I pray that you have been encouraged tonight. So thanks again for tuning in to Nightline this day. Our dear friend Michael Basmajian, he's going to take us off the air. Thanks so much. We love you from all of us at WGGS. You just take care. And right now, Michael Basmajian sings The Altar. I'm Pastor Benny. Bye-bye. Michael.
This is a song. This is an altar call. For people who don't know Jesus, I want you to call Channel 16 and give them your heart. Come to give them to the Lord. That's what this altar is for.
That's what this altar is for.
Kneel down wherever you are and give your heart to Jesus.
You don't have to care.
There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. And Jesus is waiting. He's waiting here for you. Go quickly now before they close the door. That's what this altar is for. Father is praying with his son. Mother kneels beside them, thanking God they've come. An old man is standing there in tears, giving up a part of him that he's held back for years. Hearts are being broken, lives are being changed. Those who call upon him, they will never be the same. Come quickly now before they close the door. That's what this altar is for.
That's what this altar is for.
Sing it, girls.
There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. And Jesus is waiting. He's waiting here for you. Come quickly now before they close the door. That's what this altar is for.
You
right now,
you don't have to
that you
care
pick Jesus into your heart. There's a light in the darkness. There's a love that's true. And Jesus is waiting, waiting here for you. Go quickly now before they close the door. You can give your burdens to the Lord. That's what this altar is for. Thank you, Jesus, for my life. I am brand new in you. Amen.